This was in one of the Zoom jury trials that Seattle has done. There was the defense counsel during the examination of witnesses, of a witness by plaintiff's counsel. Defense counsel had a failure and dropped out for 22 minutes before they were able to regain connectivity. They then asked the judge to repeat, just to start over again, because it obviously wasn't fair. It was no fault of their own. The judge, on the spur of the moment, just on the fly, the question came out of his mouth, what redundant systems did you have in place for this? Certainly you had to realize that this could happen. What did you do to prepare for it? They weren't able to give good enough of an explanation. And one of the explanations they gave, by the way, and this is stunning, is they had actually hired a technician. They had a technician there at the law office, but they had no redundant systems set up. They got back in using a completely different computer. So there are no, that you have to make the assumption that there are no do-overs. So the minimum requirements is not a camera and a mic. It's two cameras and two mics. You can use your phone as the backup camera and a mic, but that is really, that is very risk-taking behavior. It's best if you have two computers instead. But if you don't have two computers, use an iPad. iPads are remarkably good, remarkably and consistently fail-safe pieces of technology. I certainly have an iPad. And so that would be, if you don't have another computer, that would be your preferred device. Additionally, if you are using a laptop computer, you have the camera and the microphone built in. That is more significant than it sounds. And what is significant about that is that the manufacturer engineered that product to work perfectly symmetry between its sound card, its sound circuitry, and its microphone, between its video card and its camera. You have nothing will give you less delay and lag and greater reliability than using the camera and the mic that is in your laptop. You have to compensate. You have to learn a little bit about it, reaching up and putting it somewhere else. It limits what your options are, but I use that as a backup. So what else? You want is everybody has webcams these days. Almost everyone is doing webcams and external speakers as well, but for sure external webcams. Is the webcam can go down. It's unlikely the webcam itself is going to fail. It is not unlikely that the USB interface with that webcam is going to fail. Webcams end up having all kinds of problems. You can try to prepare for everything, and if you don't have some real redundancy going, you're just playing with fire, and you're going to have a bad experience. So there has to be two cameras, two mics. In addition to that, you need two Zoom accounts. You cannot get by with one Zoom account. You're allowed to have as many Zoom accounts as you want. All you need is just a different email for that. I have three Zoom accounts. You want to have at least two Zoom accounts. Before we got onto this, I field tested it, and I was actually logged on with both of my accounts, and then I just mute them. And so, if necessary, if my primary account went out, then I'm in a position to respond. So, do not be doing depositions until you have created your second Zoom account. What you need to have, and then by the way, and make sure that you have downloaded the app onto your devices before you do that. You have to have you have to have the app on it. You cannot wait. You also need to have, you need to, whatever you're going to be using in terms of other programs, you would be surprised at the number of times you then go over to your backup, and then you log on, and the first thing it wants is a password. And you don't remember what the password is for that. You should have already done that step. That meeting, you shouldn't be booting it up there on the spot at the time of failure, and you shouldn't be logging on them. You then go ahead and try to access a cloud such as Dropbox. Boom, it wants your password for that. In addition to that, you're having to go through all kind of next screens. You have to run through this before you start your deposition. Yes, you have court reporters who can help you with this and do it. But I'm telling you that unless you understand the technology, you are ceding way too much control, and you aren't going to be in a position to respond.